trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a
thank you. was, and what a time it was, it was. A time of innocence, a time of confidences. Long ago it must be, I have a photograph. Preserve your memories, they're all that's left you.
Don't start swearing all of a sudden. Hi.
Thank you. opportunity to present our nation's colors, and the choir sings our national anthem.
Thank you. 2014 has plenty of memories, both good and bad. I can remember all the way back to Grace Nursery School. In the mornings before class started, it was one big toddler fight to see who could get the best tricycle or Hot Wheel that they could. For me personally, I specifically remember Macy and I fighting over the shiny red one that was by far the best. For many of us, Grace Nursery School is where it all started, the beginning of our friendships, and the beginning of the adventure we'd all shared together.
Looking back on elementary school pictures, I'm starting to realize that that was the time period in most of our lives when we started losing our teeth and dressing ourselves. Thanks. Though we spent much time finger painting and reading, the best memories we have were of the playground. For example, if you could swing high and jump off the swings into the P-rocks, you were pretty cool. But if you could do a flying squirrel across monkey bar sets, that was the ultimate rebel status.
Fast forward a few quick years, and suddenly we became middle schoolers. We now shared a school with the cool big kids. Lucky for us fourth graders, we were the last class ever to have Mrs. Carrier as a teacher. Many of us remember wondering why she kept calling us by our mom or dad's name, but ended up not caring anyways because she had candy.
We were also one of the first classes to have then Miss Nelson as a teacher. Now she's Mrs. Hallberg, but I think it's safe to say that everyone has caught themselves saying, Miss Nelson, Mrs. Hallberg, whenever we see her. We feel it should be state law that teachers should not be legally able to change their last names until they retire. It is simply too hard to remember. A bonus prize for us lucky fourth graders came in the form of the middle school Olympics, which we got to participate in twice. We were the chosen people.
I recall fifth grade being an exciting time for our class. We got to go to Skate City. Looking back on the occasion, I believe the teachers must have loved taking a bus full of rambunctious kids, skating, then driving back with them all hyped up on pixie sticks, pop, and licorice. Fifth grade was also the year that we started to take flashlight tag seriously. A bunch of crazy fifth graders running around behind mats in the dark. What could possibly go wrong?
Fifth grade was also around the time that the school began enforcing a strange rule stating that students could not trade food at lunch. Needless to say, our jeans got dirtier much quicker after that, as we were forced to stealthily smuggle dripping tacos and greasy pizza across our laps under the table.
When we reached sixth grade, the story was a little different. We were the first class to ever have Mr. Stevenson. A select few of us, you know who you are, gave him a hard time, especially when it came to work time, and we escaped to the side room to goof around with whatever we found in the cupboards. Did we ever get any work done?
Also in sixth grade, we were all so fascinated by Mrs. Hines' accent that it made her history class twice as interesting. I remember being the most scared I've ever been in a math class when Austin Swenson accidentally hit Mrs. Bush in the neck with a paper wedge. He had misfired it from the end of a heavy-duty rubber band. We thought we knew what fear was until that day.
Seventh and eighth grade seemed to be the time when we started to get more creative with our troublemaking. For instance, who remembers the great mystery of the peanut butter in the library shelves? Was that ever even solved? Who knows? Let's also not forget about the time that Gus unscrewed the cap of the giant cafeteria ketchup bottle and Brody Bonneville dumped about a liter of ketchup onto his tray.
Seventh and eighth grade were the years where in a game of dodgeball, it became popular to spin a 360 and then throw it because it looked cool and was thought to help your throat gain speed. Foursquare was also a very popular game at the time to play at recess, and it became very vicious. We'll leave it at that. It also seemed as though every day the boys would play football at recess. Sure, they'd switch it up occasionally and bring a basketball or even play volleyball with the girls, but they'd always go back to playing football, and let me tell you, it was intense. I can recall various days when there were bloody noses or jammed fingers, but hey, boys are tough, right? Speaking of tough boys, who remembers when Richard Berry fell off the Sandrock Cliffs on the eighth grade bike trip. He was uninjured, and that's almost impressive.
Looking back on our junior high days, I'm surprised we can all still breathe properly after inhaling obscene quantities of Axe deodorant spray while walking through the halls. Luckily, by now, most of us have realized that when it comes to cologne, less is definitely more.
As eighth grade ended, the reality of high school set in. In between our eighth grade and freshman years, we lost a classmate. As we all know, this classmate was Ian Fossum. We can all attest to the fact that he was a good person and always knew how to make the class laugh. Ian always shared pictures and talked about his hunting adventures and let us know when he got a nice buck with his bow. In honor of him, we took our senior class photo with everyone wearing camouflage.
Let's start the high school memories off with a little reminiscing of how much our grade likes to hurl. It started in kindergarten with Chandler and Zani puking on me while riding the bus to school. Then, in elementary school, Brody Bonneville puked all over his math workbook, which he still had to use. Then, once again in middle school, Brody barfed all over his desk during the Apple Pellet video, right when the narrator was saying the word regurgitate. What are the chances? Finally, in our freshman year of high school, Cameron Lynn denied Miss Darby's request to stop chugging fruit punch. Needless to say, the fruit punch ended up being in the garbage can.
We made our freshman year's homecoming quite memorable. We did put up a fight in every single competition category and even came in second in the hallway decoration. What was really memorable, though, was the fact that we were the first class not to have a lip sync prepared for the competition.
You know, we were also the first class to have prom on a boat. That was memorable as well. Everyone loaded the boat, ate their food, and started to dance. But right when the dance was in full swing, the boat's power shut off and the lights went out.
Freshman year was also about the time that Russell Lindbaum's sweatshirt addiction became apparent. Russell has been known to frequent an outfit consisting of five shirts at once. It's a cold, cold world. Another cold claim to fame for our grade was the fact that we had probably the most snow days of any class to filter through the school.
Our time here at Grantsburg High School has been a memorable one. That goes without saying. We have made connections and friendships that will last a lifetime. We have many talented athletes, musicians, artists, and scholars in our class. And because of our diversity, we will always be remembered.
Oh. musicians, Mr. Vanetsky, band director, and Mrs. Bench. We thank you for your leadership over the years, and Mr. Marzak, and for creating one of the best graduation ceremonies around. I have to tell you that 20 years ago, I was sitting up in that corner. I had just signed a contract to come here, and I'd experienced many graduation ceremonies, but none as nice as this one. And we can contribute that to Mr. Marzak. I'm going to talk about it a little bit more, but this is his 38th graduation, and it is his last graduation. So Mr. Marzak, would you please stand? Let us give him a round of applause. What a legacy and a job well done. Class of 2014, we have enjoyed watching you grow up in school over the years. You are very talented, and we are very proud of you today. And while your teachers and your coaches are very important, it's your parents who are the major influence on your life. And parents, please stand today so that we can honor you. Give you a round of applause. Dollars to scholars, religious organizations, and volunteers that made this place special. So we thank you for all the hours of service that you have given our schools. Also, the way that the community has supported our graduates with scholarships. $90,000 was handed out Monday night to our graduates. Thank you, Grantsburg. So graduates, as you go on my journey, please know that you have our blessings. Please use your strengths as we have taught you and shine brightly and come back often. In addition to saying goodbye to these graduating seniors, we say goodbye to these retiring staff. Christine LePage taught art here for 21 years. How many have her in art? Yeah. Nancy Daniels taught first grade for 26 years. Did she teach you to read? Yeah. Bridget Nevin, 23 years. Special education in elementary, Title I in reading. Joe Luke, 24 years. How many had her for kindergarten? Stan Marzak, 43-year career, 38 years in Grantsburg. High school dean of students, 6 years. High school principal for 7 years. We thank you, a 43-year career total. All combined, this is 130 years for Grantsburg, 23,400 school days. We wish these people the very best as they go on in their future, and may your retirement be the rich and rewarding kind. Thank you for all you've given the School District of Grantsburg. Mr. Marzak was the band director for our speaker today 34 years ago. Did you know that our speaker played the trumpet at his graduation ceremony right there? Allan Johnson was born and raised in Grantsburg, Wisconsin, and graduated from Grantsburg High School in 1980. He is the son of Merlin and Carol Johnson. Please stand. Allan and his wife have three children. He earned his BS in Applied Mathematics from UW Stout in 1984. He's been a computer engineer for IBM in Rochester for 30 years. His specialty hardware and software design optimizes performance for enterprise servers. I had to find out what that was. You know the computer that beat the people on Jeopardy? Those are the big computers on which he works. He said that they range anywhere from $10,000 to $1 million. He received his project management certification in 2006, and he and his wife recently built a house on the family farm and moved back to Grantsburg. However, he continues to work for IBM from his home office. Part of his work duties include managing a team for IBM in India, Israel, Texas, and China, where he still works for IBM from his home office here in Grantsburg. So I bet 30 years ago when he graduated, he never dreamed he'd be leading work teams in foreign countries. Who knows where the future may take you. Now please give a warm Grantsburg welcome to one of our own, Allan Johnson.
Marzak, members of the school board, teachers, parents, and students. Thank you so much for inviting me to your graduation today. Today I address you as an alumni of GHS, class of 1980. As I tell you a little bit about my story, I'm going to give you some advice as you move into the next stages of your life. Like we just heard, I was born and raised in Grantsburg. This is a great spot. I like the people, the lakes, the land, the wildlife. That's why my family and I moved here last spring. We moved here to my mom's family farm on the cow pasture on Highway 48. Way back in the 60s, we did have kindergarten, but it was only 6 weeks long. Well, I missed half of it because of the chicken pox. So some say everything you really need to know you learned in kindergarten. Well, my kids tell me when I'm dumb, I tell them I only have a couple weeks worth. But in truth, learning is a lifelong process. There's always new innovation to keep up with. I went to Nelson Elementary for the first 5 grades. There were about 20 of us in each grade. I remember that we played dodgeball almost every day, sometimes even in Fayette in the gym. For me, it was the highlight of the day. So, of course, I have other interests now. But my advice here is, at all stages of life, find something that you like to do, apart from work, and enjoy. You really need this balance in life. So we made the big move to Grantsburg School for the 6th grade. Everyone there was consolidated, and we had to switch rooms between every class period. That was kind of scary. So my advice is, change is imminent, face the change, and make it a positive experience. I'm glad that both of my folks are able to be here in the audience today. You probably know my dad was the school superintendent. If you don't know him, his picture is out of the comments. How would you like it if your parent was the boss for all your teachers? Actually, everyone got along just great. So my advice to you is listen to people, act fairly, be positive, and don't burn any bridges. It's a small world and you never know who you're going to be working with or neighbors with. We had high school in the old school. The newer part of it still exists. The older part of the school had 3 floors. It was impossible to sneak around because the floors and the stairways were so squeaky. And oddly, sometimes they even made noises on their own. The teachers here at Grantsburg are great. The culture is friendly. The technology is top of the line. And there is even a priority in both sports and music. That's neat. At the entry doors, it says, Best High School. You are blessed. Build your future on that solid base. Some teachers are extraordinary and become mentors to students. One in particular impacted my life in a great way. When I was a freshman in 1976, Mr. Marzak came to teach music in Grantsburg. In the 70s, we were accustomed to getting a new band director every year or two, but I had a feeling it was going to be different this time. He had an incredible level of energy, and he was a man of integrity. Back then, Mr. Marzak had lots of dark hair. Not only did he deal with the entire high school music program, he also provided us with new, challenging opportunities, like music theory class. That was new. Well, we learned to write music in 4-part harmony, and then we got to play it in brass choir. He started a polka band, the Internationals. He did musicals with the community, I was in the orchestra for the first one, The Sound of Music. He revived the marching program when Mr. Marzak had his black and white suit on. We all thought he looked like a penguin and walked like a penguin. Mr. Marzak nurtured us to be better grown-ups, to have integrity, and to better appreciate music for the rest of our lives. One quote of his that stands out for me, and many of you are here too, to be early means to be on time, and to be on time means to be late. Congratulations to Stan Marzak as he retires, and thanks for the many life lessons. I want you to remember something special about your graduation day. Exactly 34 years ago, on this very day, May 18th, 1980, I graduated. 4 hours before the ceremony, Mount St. Helens erupted. In the month prior, many visitors flocked to see the growing bulge on the side of the mountain. Suddenly, a cubic mile of rock was ejected, with a pyroclastic flow that traveled at 400 miles an hour. It leveled 230 square miles, killing people, wildlife, and destroyed enough lumber to build 300,000 houses. The lesson is, we ought to be aware of the risk and better understand the world around us. Ben Franklin said, "By failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail." The other memory for my graduation day is playing Bugler's Holiday with two of my classmates, Peter Skinner and Craig Slander. Right after college, I went to work for IBM in Rochester, Minnesota. For 30 years now, I've been designing mid-range computers. To stay competitive, we are constantly innovating new ways to make them faster. In fact, since I started there, these systems are 1.5 million times higher performance than the ones in 1984. Albert Einstein said, "If you always do what you always did, you always get what you always got." So step back and think outside the box. Thomas Edison said, "There is a way to do it better. Find it." Creativity requires the courage to let go of certain certainties. So with years of innovation, these computers that I designed now have super scalar processor cores that each do 5 billion operations per second. We pack a bunch of these cores into a small chip to minimize latency, and it has to be small because electricity, which travels at the speed of light, goes only 1.5 inches in that 1/5 billionth of a second. So when you have hundreds of these together in one box, getting rid of heat becomes a challenge. So because we're up against this technology barrier, we have to innovate with other ideas, like 4 levels of cache for quicker data access, symmetric multi-threading for doing more things at one time, and lots of software optimization. There's a lot of focus right now in the medical community doing deep research on diseases and symptoms and medications. And we're also working on cloud. You've heard of the cloud. So it's all about innovation. Did I use those calculus rules that we learned in school? How about those chemistry and physics formulas? Well, some we did. But more importantly, it was about the thought process and cooperatively working with team members. Every day, I work with people across the globe, and I've never even met them in person. Vince Lombardi said, "People who work together will win." In school, when you do projects, you get graded on your success. But in real life, it's not that simple. Instead, we think, we create, and a lot of the time it just doesn't work. But then we look at the lessons learned and try to do it better the next time. Ben Franklin had a lot of inventions. He quoted, "I didn't fail. I just found 100 ways to do it wrong." So graduates, in closing, you have all the power that you need to be creative, to pursue your dreams, and to make our world a better place. Congratulations, and God bless.
Class of 2014 stands before you in eager anticipation of what the future holds outside the boundaries of Grantsburg High School. Seniors, thank you for your contributions to our school community. I trust that the adventure of high school has prepared you properly for the next phase of your adventure. Some of you will now go off to work, some to the military, and many of you will go on to further education. As a class, you have left your mark on Grantsburg during these past 12 years. And Grantsburg has also had a role in shaping your history as well. You have created bonds and memories which are going to remain with you for the rest of your lives. As a class, you have celebrated many good times. You've walked together also through many difficult times. Individually and as a class, you have experienced a depth in your journey, preparing you for adulthood. Early in your educational journey, you have experienced the heartache that sometimes comes into our lives. The accidental death of Ian Fossum has permanently impacted your class. In the midst of tragedy, you have grown closer together, and you have learned how to lean on each other in time of need. I have seen your vibrancy, your strength, and your ability to reach out in love to each other. During the past years, you have grown as you have walked together through joy and sadness. You have created many GHS memories, and you are now ready to create new memories in wherever life may take you. During your journey, you have also learned to serve each other, to serve the school, and to serve the community. Successful people, we have said this many times to you, successful people give back. And because serving is a valued action, I want to take a moment to publicly recognize those of you who have logged over 100 hours of community service. As I read your names, please stand. Catherine Rod, 100 hours. Keith Ballendorf, 103 hours. Alyssa Bader, 136 hours. Rebecca Curtin, 139 hours. Jacob Onstead, 172 hours. Brittany Butler, 200 hours. And receiving this year the Community Service Award for 2014, Haley Larsen with 546 recorded hours. Congratulations. Speaking of serving, I want to recognize those of you who are going to be going off to serve in our armed forces. With the following, please stand. Jake Carlson, going into the Air Force. Harley Hennessy, into the Marines. Bill Lemire, into the Air Force. Corey Peterson, into the Marines. Jaden Cook, into the Air Force. Hope Tucker, into the Air Force Air National Guard. Damon Roberts, the Air Force Reserves. We thank you for serving our country. As an academic institution, I want to recognize our valedictorian for 2014, Austin Handy, and our salutatorian for 2014, Haley Larsen. I'm thankful that I've been able to share part of this journey with you. And for one last time, as you've heard me say many times, I love you dearly, and I'm going to pray for your continued success. Superintendent Bergen and school board members, it gives me great pleasure to certify these students as having completed all requirements as stipulated by the Grantsburg School Board in the state of Wisconsin. We are privileged to confer upon these students a Grantsburg High School diploma with all of the rights and privileges thereby associated. Students, as I read your name, please come forward to receive your diploma. Parents, please feel free to move about in order to take pictures. Please refrain from applause and comments until the entire class has received their diploma. Now, we will issue diplomas to the class of 2014. Jacob Onstead. Joseph Gaffney. Haley Larsen. Brooke Roos. Kaylee Murphy. Chandler Witzani. Hope Tucker. Brody Bonneville. J.C. Coleman. Austin Handy. Catherine Rod. Raylan Hoffman. Gus Johnson. Joseph Dumas. Robert Timmer. Erlyn Olson. Damon Roberts. Austin Thoreen. Macy Hansen. Wendy Roberts. Bethany Sagner. Tiffany Peterson. Samantha Nelson. Brittany Butler. Gabrielle Banks. Jaden Cook. Marta Benelli. Mansuri Chintanavisit. Irina Dorobayeva. Rebecca Curtin. Ryan Rothbauer. Corey Peterson. Alyssa Bader. Rebecca Glover. Nathan Lewis. Brianna Barnard. Brianna Johnson. Mariah Anderson. Heidi Porky. Abigail Stevens. Joshua Friedestahl. Russell Limbaugh. Jared Benedict. Kenneth Schulte. Austin Swenson. Lars Thorson. Samantha Stokely. Nicholas Britton. Summer Anderson.
Woo!
Zachary Joacom. Richard Berry. Ethan Longhenry. Jake Carlson. Keith Volendorf. William Lemire. Harley Hennessy. Cameron Lynn. Tyler Schronzi. Amanda Campana. Amanda Gifford. Tyler Mitchell. Congratulations to the class of 2000. Sometimes the most ordinary things could be made extraordinary simply by doing them with the right people. I believe this is true when it comes to the time we have spent with each other. Each of you has made at least one day in my life something I will always remember. Whether it's sitting at the lunch table talking about everything under the sun, or the first day in school in which we welcome one another back. It's those moments I can revisit again and again in my mind and never get tired of living. And with each recollection, we remind ourselves how fortunate we are to have lived and attended school here in Grantsburg. This is where we became wiser, if you choose to believe that, and found out who our closest friends are. We can look around this town and see the memories materialized in front of us, hear the laughter, and see the joy on our faces just by being around our favorite people. And unfortunately, it comes time for us all to part ways. Although this is difficult, and knowing that we won't be returning Monday morning, this isn't goodbye. This is merely a see you later scenario, and we're all destined to meet again someday. After all, that is what reunions are for. And after we're done here, please, do not say goodbye or think of relationships being severed. We're all destined to meet again someday. It may not be tomorrow or a month from now, but it will happen. And when you want it to be now, just open up the yearbook and let the pictures move and come to life as you recall everything we did as the class of 2000. Good luck to you all. Now let's go make some new memories. We thank you for coming to the graduation ceremony for class of 2014. At the end of the ceremony, members of the graduating class of 2014 can be congratulated and given your best wishes outside of the high school in a receiving line. At this time, it is my pleasure and honor to present to you the class of 2014.
How many special people change? How many lives are living strange? Where were you while we were getting high? Slowly walking down the hall, faster than a cannonball. Where were you while we were getting high? Someday you will find me caught beneath the landslide in a champagne supernova in the sky. Someday you will find me caught beneath the landslide in a champagne supernova, a champagne supernova in the sky.
Coffee!
shall be the change.